That's drunk.
Imagine being really into comic books as a kid in the early to mid-90s and the Super Nintendo and Genesis superhero games start coming out with stuff like X-Men Mutant Apocalypse, Death and Return of Superman, Maximum Carnage, X-Men and X-Men 2 for Genesis, all sorts of Batman games, all these great games that are spot on and representing each comic's universe, and hey, check this out, an Incredible Hulk game, that's gotta be good. And look at this cover, this looks badass. I mean, you can't screw up a game starring the Hulk. Well, you can if it's made by Probe Entertainment, the same team behind games like Batman Forever and Rise of the Robots. This game isn't that bad, but it's certainly not very good. It's a 2D action platformer beat-em-up style game that's just boring and repetitive. You play as the Hulk through 5 levels, with bosses straight from the comic like the Abomination, Rhino, Absorbing Man, Tyrannus, and eventually the Leader as the final boss. In the meantime, you wander around cityscapes, dungeons, and alien bases fighting the same enemies over and over, jabs and uppercuts, just punch and punch some more. You can also pile drive enemies, which is nice, and do a huge stomp on them, as well as Hulk's thunderclap, which is just slightly underwhelming. This isn't exactly Batman Returns in terms of that satisfying feel you get from kicking ass. The moves all feel very flimsy, which really sucks considering it's the freaking Incredible Hulk. Even at his maximum power, which you can get by collecting these small green-purple pills, Hulk's attacks just feel underwhelming, especially compared to other beat-em-ups. Stuff like wrecking this phone booth and tossing it is a nice idea in theory, but it comes across so flatly. It doesn't help that the enemy design here is boring as it gets. You get 2 or maybe 3 different varieties of enemies for each level, shooting projectiles at close range or from further away, or just lunging at you. The level design here is awful too. The long-range enemies can hit you from off-screen. What the hell is that? Another annoying thing is that you have to press A to pick up health and power-ups. That might just be my own pet peeve, but why can't I just walk over the thing? Nope, you gotta line up exactly with the item and press down and A. It's just irritating. The one interesting mechanic this game has going for it is the Tranquility Pills. They allow you to revert the Hulk back to Bruce Banner, and that enables you to reach areas that you otherwise couldn't. Just press select to change him, and select to change back. The thing is, though, you're helpless in that form unless you stumble upon a laser, which you can only shoot twice. What bothers me the most about this game, though, is that it does such a poor job representing the Hulk universe. Nearly every aspect of this game feels so utterly generic, like they could put absolutely anyone in this game fighting enemies and whatever, and it wouldn't make any difference. The Hulk sprite does look pretty cool, but the settings, design, enemies, and even the bosses just don't do the world justice. I mean, look at a game like War of the Gems. Now that looks like a superhero game. Incredible Hulk, not so much. The music is especially bad. I mean, it's not that bad on its own, but it just doesn't fit the game at all. That sounds like I'm playing Sterling Sharp end-to-end football, not the Incredible Hulk. The sound design is at least okay, making a huge rumbling sound when the Hulk lands from a jump. That's a nice touch. But man, I can't get over the music, it's just so out of place. This version of Incredible Hulk was also released for Genesis, Sega Master System, and Game Gear, and they're all more or less the same game, just maybe with some minor level design changes here and there. I will say I think the Genesis version of this game is slightly better. The controls feel smoother, so the combat feels a bit more satisfying, and of course the game plays a bit faster, which always helps when playing a boring game like this, but rest assured, it's the same boring enemies and same boring layouts. So yeah, unfortunately, the Incredible Hulk for Super Nintendo is just not worth playing today. The ability to change back into Bruce Banner is a neat idea, but they don't take advantage of it here because the level design is so generic. That word by itself sums up this game. In fact, I could have done you all a favor and just made this video like 10 seconds long and just say, nope, it's totally generic. If you really want to play a 16-bit game starring the Incredible Hulk, your best bet is War of the Gems. That game's not exactly perfect, but it's a heck of a lot better than this one.